and we are students of First Seminary at Virginia Business School, and today we are going to tell you about what we have been working and doing in several biology lessons. This project has been proposed by STEM for Young, and with the collaboration of the local government of Campo de Uso, that has given us the licenses for the Aerohydrographic Confederation and for the use of a boat. So Birdland has also collaborated. She indicates us where they should we put the nest and help us with the design.
Our project. We are going to try to build a nest that should float on water. Our main objective is to understand how an engineer works with the engineering design process. As it is the way to work that the Stanford job has provided us instead of working with the scientific method. Here we have several images about what this process is about, in which we will be based on the whole project.
Here we can see our first activity we have done to make the nest. This is the beginning activity. This activity consists of making a mind map, so the first thing we need to know is to answer several questions, which were about engineering, about what engineering is, that is a place application of scientific knowledge to solve everyday life problems, what an engineer does, what are the most famous things of engineering. In our town highlights the metallurgical, because we work a lot with the metal. And the robotics is also a very large type of engineering. And finally, the last question was what technology means, that is the collection of techniques, skills, methods, and processes. And this is the process that my partner and the rest of us.
Another activity in the initial step was making a table with only a newspaper and some sticking tape. Here we can see some images of the project. And we have to know how to put the laptop to support the weight. And we have to spread the engineering design process. And the deal was a success, but there was a problem. The lack of ventilation was enough for the laptop, so it overheated. We had this with the tables by placing books to simulate it with the laptop. And here we can see an example of one who supported the way.
In the first activity, we answered some questions about the first instruction to start making the nest. And we have also done a diagram with the criteria and the criteria that the teacher just for.
First, we can identify the main problem. So is the nest have to float, and we have six sub-problems, that is, it must float, stability, it must be attractive for birds, eco-friendly, waterproof, and resist the eggs. If we solve all these sub-problems, we will get the answer to the main problem.
In activity 3, we explore the site. To do this, we did some experiments to come out with the solution of our sub-problems. In the first step experiment, we are going to come from a dynamometer weights with different sizes, and depending on the weight, we will check if the dynamometer is stretching longer or shorter in the water or in the air. Our conclusion was that we thought that the dynamometer would stretch less in the water because the water would slow it down due to the force, while in the air, it will stretch more because there is nothing that can stop it. And the data we obtained was that with a small weight, the dynamometer stretched until 1 newton in the air and 0.75 newtons in the water. Later, we tried with a medium weight, and in this case, the dynamometer stretched until 1.75 newtons in the air and 1.5 newtons in the water. And finally, we tried with a large weight, and in this case, the dynamometer stretched until 5 newtons in the air and 4.25 meters in the water. We investigate about the Archimedes principle too, which states that all of the submerged in a fluid experience a vertical and upward force that is equal to the weight of fluid displaced.
In the second experiment, we are going to try to sink two balloons into the water, one small and another big. We are going to predict which one will be more difficult to sink, and then get a conclusion.
our radio. We thought that the small balloon would be easier to sink because the big balloon moves to the sides, so it would be more difficult to sink. What we got was that the small balloon was easier to sink than the big balloon. So we draw the same conclusion as in the previous experiment, since we have to see the force exerted by the water, since it is equal to the weight of the displaced fluid.
In the third experiment, we are going to put some weights of different sizes and weights in a container, and we are going to change the combination until the plastic container can float and it doesn't sink. First, we put so many weights, so it sank, and that's why we decided to take out some weights until it finally floated. Our conclusion on this was, when the container has too much weight, the weight or the force of the container was greater than the one of the pushing force. And when we were taking out some weight, the pushing force became stronger than the body that was submerging. Then the body finally rises and floats in the fluid.
In the fourth experiment, we are going to grab a little bicarbonato in some paper napkin with a weight of 20 grams. We put in a basket and throw it in the water. We suppose that first it sinks and then rises and floats. And luckily, we did it right the first time. So that way is because the density of it is greater than the density of the water. But when the vinegar and the baking soda react, makes its density lower than the density of the water.
Activity 4 consists in finding the solutions for each sub-problem, but like we have already investigated the science, so it was easier to find the solution. It must float. We decided to put some pool noodles as a base, but we realized that with these noodles, the nest wouldn't last for a long time. So instead, we changed them by some PVC pipe. Stability. To solve this problem, we have to take into account the size of the base, which must be about 45 centimeters. And to avoid the movement of the nest or the current that can take it away, we have thought to tie a rope to a weight underneath the nest. Adaptiveness. We are going to place feathers, little branches, leaves, so the nest looks real. There is no specific solution for this. The only thing that we can do is trying to use as little plastic as we can. Waterproof. We are going to use impermeable materials. That is to say, we have to avoid to put the nest on water and be floating.
Especially when the bird moves. Second step, we will change the plastic around the eggs by a tie. This will make the nest more stable and safer. And the last step, we have changed the pool noodles by PVC pipes to be more resistant because the pool noodles can be the resilient easily. And this is the final result that is this.
Here we can see some examples of the species of birds that can make the nest in our room. This photo belongs to our friend and teacher, our school, Manuel Esteban Cliff, a great expert photographer.
We thought to place the nest in these four red points, but in the end, we only put the nest in these only two red points, because there is sites where the level of the water don't fluctuate too much. They are located in the Ebro Reservoir in Campo Cantabria. Moreover, no.
One month ago, we went to the Ebro Reservoir. squad to put our chicken nest on water. We went by group to put the nest. When the second group went to put the nest on water, they found that the first one had sand, because we had sticked the plastic cover pipes back. Next week we are going to improve and repair the failing nest and put it on water again. Some friends have seen a couple of fish live near the nest, so we hope they can breed on it.
While we were carrying out this project, we have learned a lot of things. For example, we understand the Archimedes principle on the science field, because this principle was the reason why our prediction was true in a lot of experiments. We also have learned how an engineer works with the engineering design process, due to the reason that we have been working with this process on the whole project. And finally, we also have learned, associated to biology, the physics features of the great crystal beam, the physical conditions, the habitat, what they eat, and all of these things.
We have actually really good experiences, which will be useful for our future, like speaking public, defending our project in front of a jury or any other kind of audience. We like our experience of the science fair too, because it was really fun, and we are also very proud of our work done there.
We want to thank all the people that formed STEM4YOUT for this STEM project, our school that always take part of this good project, and of course our teachers David Tejido and Daniel Rucandio, and also Celina, our English teacher. Thank you.
Cristina was the main designer of the activity.
Yes, indeed.
From Greece.
My colleague.
So, any question for
me? I can start again. Can I start? So, you said that the first nest turned. You then fixed it and you then placed it back. Yes. So do you now have two nests there, floating, in this place?
Yes, we are going to repair the same nest. Next week we are going to put in the Euron server with the other nest. The other nest was floating and it was great, but this we are going to repair, because the only thing that is was wrong was that the PVC pipe was badly
sealed. Ah, so they got water inside.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
I have a question. What's that thing that you have on the top of the table?
It's a prototype of the big net. This is like the real nest of the Euro server, but